Hi, I'm Sebastian from Beamex. In this video, I'll be calibrating these two Pt100 sensors simultaneously and automatically. To do so, I would need to have a heat source, and I'm going to be using the Beamex MC6-T. This dry block, one of the features it has is that it has three RTD channels, meaning I could be measuring both of the sensors simultaneously. I will be using my internal reference sensor, but if I would like to, I could use an external reference sensor and connect it to the third RTD channel. One of the cool functions the MC6-T has is called group calibration, and this allows me to capture each sensor's readings simultaneously and automatically. It saves me a lot of time because I only need to ramp the temperature up once. Before I get to the calibration event itself, I need to either send the instruments from my calibration management software, CMX or Logical, or create the instruments in the MC6-T manually. I've already sent these instruments from my calibration management software, so I can continue straight to the documenting calibrator mode. This is where you create your group. The sensors that I'm calibrating, they are in the same temperature range, 30 to 50 Celsius. They could be different ranges, but only thing you need to take into mind or take into account is that don't exceed the temperature for any of these sensors. I start with creating the group, and I choose which sensors to include to this group. I already have the PT101 there. I'll choose the PT202, include it into the group, and close the group. Now I can view information on all of the sensors that I have in my group. I only have two now here. I have the position name, device, all that. I also see that my range is 30 to 50 Celsius. I see that the PT101 needs to be connected to first RTD channel. The PT202 needs to be connected to third RTD channel. I can now hit start. And what you see on the display is, on the top left corner, internal reference temperature. And I'm now going for the 30 Celsius set point. On the top right corner, I see my sensor value. In this case, it is the first sensor, the PT101. So this is the temperature of that temperature sensor. The blue lines are the upper and lower error limits. I want my readings to be between these two lines. As long as it stays there, I'm going to have a pass calibration. If it goes below or above, it's going to be a failed calibration. I can also tap on the top of the display and I get to this graphical view of the calibration. I see my temperature on the left side and stability numbers or value in the right side. The thicker line is the temperature reading. So I have both the input and output here, and I have my stability line, which is the thinner line. So we see now that we are increasing temperature towards 30 degrees Celsius. The ramp is going up. The closer we get to the set point, the closer the stability line is going to go towards these smaller numbers. The smaller this number is, the more stable the signal. I will now let this calibration run its course. Fully automatic, whenever it reaches the first set point, it's going to record the reading for the first sensor, switch over to the second sensor, and also capture that reading. Then it's going to give the second set point, and the same procedure continues. Fully automatic, I'll let it run its course, and I'll come back when it's got some readings. The calibration has now reached the third set point, and I can see that the slope or the signals for the stability is getting closer and closer to these small numbers. The temperature signals, this red line is the internal reference, and the blue line is the PT101 sensor at the time. Here you can see that the temperature is stabilizing both temperature value and stability value. And now when I look at the reading, we are getting very close to reaching the 50 Celsius set point. When we reach there, the MC6-T will first record the first channel, Pt101, automatically switch over to the second channel and also record that temperature reading. The countdown has started. You're gonna hear first one beep. It switched automatically to the second channel and a second beep. And I have a pass calibration. I see my error, also how big the significance of it is. I can add notes if I like, and this will be visible in the calibration certificate. I can see the results in a graphical view and also then in numerical view. And if I like to add some environmental information, that is also possible in this window. So these results are saved for both sensors, and my job is done. I would upload these results to the calibration management software, either CMX or Logical, have my supervisor approve the results, and job is finished. And this is how easy it is to simultaneously calibrate two PT100 sensors automatically. If you want to learn more, please visit our YouTube channel. Thank you, and see you next time.